There are countless number of settings and tweaks in your Android phone, but not all settings are good for every user. In fact, there are many Android settings that you should change right now and for a good reason. For example, you can't risk your privacy by leaking your searching behavior or device usage behavior. Well, this is just one example. There are many more, including the ones that will improve your Android phone's battery life. So make sure you watch until the end of this video. Hello everyone, I'm Rahul from Tech Repo. And in this video, I'll show you 17 secret Android settings that you should change right now. But before we proceed, make sure you subscribe to Tech Repo channel and tap on the bell icon so that you never miss an important update. Now, without further delay, let's get started. In security and location settings, there's device security setting where you can set your device lock preferences. Simply tap on this settings cog icon and check your settings for automatic lock. By default, your device locks down 5 seconds or more after sleep. So if someone snatches your phone from your hand, he can still access your phone completely as your phone takes 5 seconds or more to get locked, thus making your device more vulnerable. Simply change these settings and set the automatically lock to immediately after sleep. Now, if someone snatches your phone from your hand, simply press the power button and your device will not only sleep but also automatically lock. Personally, I would also turn these settings off. Because if I keep this enabled, this will keep my phone unlocked based upon certain environment or conditions offered by Android's Smart Lock functionality. I have tested Android Smart Lock multiple times and it has failed to meet up my expectations. So personally, I don't trust the Smart Lock and hence I prefer not to use Android's Smart Lock functionality. You shouldn't be surprised if I say your Android device is leaking lots of data. Google is tracking you everywhere and based upon your search behavior, Google shows you personalized interest-based ads. You might be thinking, what is personalized interest-based ads, right? Let me explain. If you search for iPhone in Google, Google tracks you and knows that you are interested in iPhone. So whichever website you visit on the web, Google is more likely to show you ads for iPhone. It's because Google thinks that since you are interested in iPhone, you are more likely to purchase an iPhone. This is personalized interest-based ads. You can change settings on your Android phone to stop Google from using your search behavior for ads personalization. Go to Google settings and in services, tap on ads. Now turn on the settings to opt out of ads personalization. Also, you might also like to reset advertising ID so that any previously built ad profiles on your device can be deleted. Third one is hiding sensitive content from lock screen. By default, Android shows you sensitive content from the notifications on the lock screen. This can be helpful for many as you can see what's inside notification without unlocking your phone. But if you are a privacy buff, you can't risk your privacy by showing sensitive content. Go to apps and notification settings, tap on notifications, then on lock screen. By default, it is showing all notifications. But here you can set to hide sensitive content or don't show notifications at all. Simply hide sensitive content and you are good to go. Google Assistant is a powerful tool as you can even unlock your phone with your voice simply by saying OK Google. But this is often less secure as anyone else having a voice similar to yours can unlock your device if his voice matches your voice model. If you want better security for your device, you need to instantly turn these settings off. To do so, go to security and location. Under device security, tap on smart lock. Now input your password or pattern for unlocking your phone, then tap on voice match and turn off the settings to unlock with voice match. I don't know about your preferences, but I personally don't like to share my location constantly, as this not only helps Google track me everywhere but also consumes battery juice. However, you might want to enable Android Device Manager from Find My Device settings. Go to Security and Location settings and tap on Find My Device. Now turn it on. This is crucial because if you ever lost your phone, you might be able to track it later. Before I talk about SIM card lock, make sure you contact your cellular network provider and get the PUK code for your SIM card, so that if something goes wrong, you might easily fix it. If you enable SIM card lock functionality, you will require a PIN to use your SIM when you restart your phone. It's a nice security enhancement and saves you from the risk of unauthorized use of your SIM card. Now, let's talk about some keyboard settings that you should change right now on your Android phone. If you are typing something, you need to frequently deal with text as well as numbers. You might want to bring number row in the keyboard so that you may quickly access both. To enable number rows in keyboard, long press on comma button and it will take you to keyboard settings. I am using Google's default keyboard, that is Gboard, but the process is similar in case you are using other third-party keyboards as well. Under preferences, turn on number row. This will always show number row no matter what orientation of keyboard you are using. While typing anything, it often slows down my speed when I type something and Gboard automatically corrects it to something else which wasn't my intention. If you have ever been in a similar situation, you need to turn off autocorrect settings. From the keyboard settings page, tap on text correction and scroll all the way down to autocorrection. Turn off autocorrection and now it will never slow down your typing speed. I don't know why Android automatically adds new app shortcuts on the home screen whenever users download new apps, because this is annoying for many, including me. You can turn this off simply by long pressing on the home screen, then tapping home settings, followed by toggling left add icon to home screen. This will stop adding shortcuts for new apps on the home screen. If you go to settings, then connected devices, then connection preferences, this will show you all the connection modes your phone has got, like Bluetooth, Android Beam, NFC, etc. NFC stands for near field communication, which allows you to exchange data when your phone touches another device. NFC is a very powerful tool to easily share data with your friends and co-workers, but there are not many Android users who use NFC. And bad thing is, Android phone has NFC enabled by default. You need to change this Android settings right now and turn off NFC, as this will not only make your device less vulnerable but also improve your battery performance. Google Instant Apps is a useful functionality on your Android phone which allows you to play games or try apps without downloading or installing. But currently it's under beta and not available for everyone. However, you can try it now simply by making some changes in your Android phone's settings. Open Play Store app and go to its menu by tapping the hamburger icon. Now, scroll all the way down to settings. Under User Controls, you will find an option to use apps without installation. Tap on that and you will see a list of emails available. Choose the one you want and tap Yes, I am in. That's it. Now you can try apps without installing or downloading. Android animations are quite good already, but if you want to spice up things, you can simply speed up animations in the developer options. But if you don't have a developer account, don't worry. Simply go to Settings, System, then go to About Phone. Scroll down until you find Build Number. Tap 7 times on the build number. And this will ask you to enter your PIN or pattern. Now it will show you that you are a developer and your phone has got developer options. Now go back and tap on Advanced. And this will show you developer options. Now scroll all the way down until you see transition animation scale. Change the animation scale and notice the difference. You will find your phone a lot more speedy now. Few months back, Google introduced Google Play Protect app in the Play Store and made available for every Android user. Since then, Google Play Protect has continuously scanned apps on Android devices and found a huge number of harmful apps in the Play Store. My question is, why Google risked users' device security by allowing the deployment of these apps on the Play Store? Well, that's a different story, but you can certainly change some Android settings and help Google Play Protect scan for harmful apps in a better way. Simply go to Settings, Security and Location, tap on Google Play Protect and turn on the settings that says Improve Harmful App Detection. That's it. Now this will send any unknown app in your device to Google for better detection. One of the most common questions I get from Android users is how can I speed up my slow Android phone? Freeing up space is one of those quick actions you can do to speed up your slow Android phone. Well, you already know that. So what's new here, right? And most of times, we forget manually deleting unnecessary files. Thankfully, you can automate this process if you have an Android phone with Android 6.0 or later. Simply go to Settings, Storage, and turn on Smart Storage. Smart Storage automatically free up space on your phone by clearing backed up photos and videos from your device storage. If you have ever used Google Chrome or any other browser, you must be knowing about autofill feature that makes your work easier and faster by automatically filling up previously saved password and login credentials. It's like keychain on Apple devices. You can utilize the similar autofill feature on Android to automatically fill login credentials on various websites and apps as well. Go to Settings, tap on System, followed by Languages and Input. In Advanced Settings, there is Autofill Service. By default, it would be None. Choose Google as that would be the most secure option. Tap OK and you are ready to speed things up. In the same autofill service, your credit card details can also be saved. Despite Google's autofill being one of the most trusted options, I don't trust it enough to let it save my credit card details. And for an obvious reason, I would recommend you to recheck it and remove your credit card details if it has saved it already. Last but not least, this is a very useful battery saving hack for your Android phone. Various apps that you install on your Android device constantly drain your battery by running in the background. While letting the apps constantly run in the background is good for important apps like messaging apps or email, etc. You can certainly limit various less important apps from draining battery. Go to Settings, Battery, and tap on Adaptive Battery. Turn it on. Now your phone will automatically learn your device usage behavior and limit down the battery for those apps that you don't use quite frequently. So these were 17 secret Android settings that I believe you should change right now, as this will not only enhance your Android experience but also make your Android device more secure. Hope you found this video helpful. If you enjoyed watching this video, please hit the like button and share with your friends to help them learn. Also, if you want more cool tips, tricks and tutorials, please subscribe to Tech Repro channel and tap on the bell icon so that you never miss an important update. And before I go, don't forget to check out the description to find out more information about how you can participate in the giveaway and win amazing gifts. Thanks for watching. This is Rahul signing off and I'll see you in the next video.